Welcome back to Blue Hens Beat. I'm Scott Klatzkin, another edition of Club Corner. Another national champion. This time we're here with the UD Figure Skating Club, and I'm here with Julianne. And Julianne, you're a member of the national championship team. Tell me what that's like to win a national championship.
It was amazing. Everyone worked really hard and it all came together at the end. It was really close, so it was awesome to win. It was the best feeling and we're all so excited about it.
Obviously a very demanding sport, a lot of hours, a lot of practice that I'll find out a little bit later about how much practice goes into doing something like that. But all day long, I'm sure you're in here. How do you manage with classes and your schedule and your social life to be in such a demanding sport?
It's definitely hard. During the week, we have one team practice at 6:40 in the morning, so that is pretty early, but there's so much going on here, so much ice. We can all come in, skate at different times, working around our class schedule, which is awesome. So it's pretty flexible, but we all definitely put a lot of hours and work into everything, both on and off the ice.
I've never been in skates before. I rarely even do cold weather, let alone ice and in an arena. So this is gonna be fun for me. You guys are gonna show me how to skate.
Definitely, we're excited. Sounds good.
Right. Tie them tight. All right.
Especially the bottom.
Tie the bottom. Yeah, what is the lawsuit? How much money can I win when I do break my neck? Have we calculated that up yet? Think about that. All right, we're back here. I'm ready for my lesson. I'm here with Melinda. She teaches a class here. It's meant for 3-year-olds and younger kids, and well, basically people at my level. I'm horrible at this. I'm very nervous right now. I'm within an arm's reach of the wall, so I feel safe right now. Hopefully I'll feel safe with you. All right, let's do it. Make me a figure skater.
All right, we're gonna start with our hands up.
Hands up.
Called airplane arms.
Airplane arms.
And we're gonna take little marching.
Oh, okay.
So pick up your feet.
Now we're having fun. Okay.
Little marching steps.
I'm doing it. Okay.
All right, ready?
I'm not ready for much else.
So we're gonna put our hands in front.
Okay.
Bend down.
Ooh, okay.
Like you're singing.
Here we go.
That's it.
Okay. That was good, right?
Yeah, that was good.
Nailed
excellent.
It.
All right. Would you like to try and keep moving?
Okay. Oh, the fall is coming soon.
That's okay. We okay. Teach them how to
fall.
Up.
Okay.
Would you like to fall?
Not on purpose. We'll get into that, but. Won't be anything I'm trying to do.
All right, how about let's go backwards? We're going to do backward wiggles.
That seems advanced.
Wiggle our feet back and forth.
Here. I feel like I'm not moving, though.
Just, can we go like
let's
one,
go.
Two, three?
Okay, and go.
I'm going to do that. No, we're going to get that done. We're going to make that happen. I'm doing it. Here we go. All right. Ooh, coming at you, camera. Keep up. Keep up. Keep up.
All right. We'll do a lunge. Okay,
we'll do a lunge?
Speed.
All right.
And then I'll show you. All right, ready?
It's like a ride.
All right, ready?
Yep. Where am I going? Oh, jeez. That didn't work out as well as I thought it would. How do I get up? All right. That didn't work out, but we're gonna keep on trying because I want one of those banners.
Right.
I wanna be a part of the next national championship team. So if this is training, then I have to work hard for that. That was one of my goals that I set out today, was to be a world-class skater. And I'm gonna get there.
No, he's going to jerk forward.
No, that's true. He'll jerk forward, actually.
Kind of like a car crash, like someone rear-ends.
The goal at the end of this is for me to survive. All right, well, thank you so much. I feel like I'm a master at skating now. So if I were to want to try out or be a part of the club, which I obviously need years and years and years of practice for, how would someone get involved in the club?
Well, you would need to buy your own pair of skates.
Okay.
That's the first step. Second step is make sure you can do at least some elements, like a spin or jump. And then we'll put together a program with music and you'll have to get a costume and you're pretty much all set.
What is your glitter and sequins budget like? Because I need to have all out if I'm joining this.
Well, it's all coming out of your own money, so.
Whatever you want.
Yes.
Whatever you want. Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, you talked about putting together programs. Talk to me individually about the programs that you guys do, what it entails and how long you've been doing them for.
Okay, well, with me, I have my coach here, Tiffany, and when we're first starting a program, we pick out a piece of music and edit it to be how long it needs to be for my level of skating, And then US Figure Skating puts out a list of elements of all the things that need to go in your program. So we kind of just get out here and start from scratch, putting together choreography, all the jumps, all the spins, and tilts together. And then after we're done, I just practice it over and over again.
As far as University of Delaware, just a lot of very talented individuals come through this program and have skated here at the Ice Arena. Why has the University of Delaware had so much success in bringing people in, bringing talent like yourselves into the campus?
I think it's the history, like the rank especially. If you look around at all the banners, there's so many people that have trained here and gone on to win nationals or go to the Olympics. So I feel like it's a legacy that's just continuing and that draws people in.
These ladies are back in action on November 5th at Cornell. For more information, go to udel.edu/recreation. Coming up next, Blue Hens Barbara answers your email. I'm gonna go skate.